Okay. So we will actually talk about two major ways that we can use to find limits. The first way is to do it using a graph, which is what we do last time. So last time we talked about if we are given a graph of a function, then how can we use that to find the limit? And this is actually not that bad, we just have to know where to look. So for today, we will go through the other method, which is to use the algebra. And there are a few identities that will help us when we want to find the limit using algebra. So let me go through a few of these. They are basically these guys. So the limit of a constant is just a constant. The limit of x when x goes to a is gonna just equal to a. The limit of 1 over x, so this one is easier seen using the graph. The limit of 1 over x when x approaches 0 from the left is going to be negative infinity. When x approaches 0 from the right, that's going to be positive infinity. That will be this way. The limit of x to the n when n goes to infinity is going to be infinity if n is bigger than 0, and 0 if n is less than infinity. So if I were to look at an example, if I have the limit of x squared when x goes to infinity. Well, when x goes to infinity, x squared is going to get extremely big, so this guy is going to be just infinity. So the cutoff, again, is when the exponent is bigger than 0, it's going to be infinity. But if I do the limit when x goes to 0 of, let's see, x to the negative 2, so this is going to be when my n is less than 0 now. Notice that this is actually the same as the limit when x goes to infinity of 1 over x squared. And when x gets really big, 1 over x squared is going to get really small, and this guy is going to just equal to 0. So this coincides with the second item that I have here. If the exponent is negative, then the limit are going to be 0. This applies to, let's say, a fractional limit as well. Let's say if my limit is fractional, like x to the 1/2. This is, again, limit of square root of x when x goes to infinity. So when x goes to infinity, square root of x is still going to be quite large. So that's going to be, once again, infinity. And that coincides with my first rule here. The other rule, the exponent rule, goes a little different. The cutoff is going to be whether a is bigger than 0 or a is less than 0 when x is in the exponent and the base is a. So let's see, for example. If my function is 2 to the x, so again, when x gets really large, 2 to the x is going to get really, really large. So this guy is going to be infinity. So this falls in the first case when my base is bigger than 1. On the other hand, if I have the limit when x goes to infinity of 1 over 2 to the x, which is going to be my second case now when my base is less than 1. This guy, this is actually the same as the limit when x goes to infinity of 1 over 2 to the x. When x goes to infinity, 2 to the x is going to get really, really large. And when I divide 1 by a number that is really, really large, I'm going to get a number that is really, really small. So this whole thing is going to just equal to 0. So these are the basic rule. You can also, when you see a constant multiplied to a function and you want to take limit, what you can also do is you can pull that constant out and just find the limit of a function. And also, the limit of x plus or minus g is going to be just the limit of f plus or minus the limit of g, the limit of f times g. It's just limit of f times limit of g. It goes a little differently when you have fraction though, because the limit of f over g is going to be limit of f over limit of g if I knew that the limit of g is not going to be 0. when it is equal to zero, then we will need some work to deal with that. So this is the basic way to deal with limit algebraically. However, most of the time when you deal with limit, your questions will not be so straightforward. Let me actually put it this way. When you use the algebra to find the limit, most of the time the function that you'll see are going to be a fraction. Like what I'm looking at here, they are all fractions. And most of the time, what you are going to see will fall into one of the four cases. Maybe you will get just a non-zero constant. So let me just put a constant. If it is a fraction, maybe you will get a constant over zero. Maybe you will get zero over the constant. Or you will get zero over zero. Usually, if you get the constant, that's going to be just the answer immediately. So that's it. If you get a constant over zero, you'll need to do a little bit more work. What you'll eventually have is that it should either be infinity, negative infinity, or doesn't exist. We will go over the details in a moment, whether how can we define which one of the three the limit is going to equal to. When you get zero over constant, well, zero divided by any number is just going to be zero. When you get zero over zero, this is going to be the worst case. This is going to be when you'll have to do some work. You'll have to simplify and see what you're going to get. Now, from time to time, you'll also have to deal with the limit when x goes to infinity. So again, several things can happen here. Maybe you get just a constant. Maybe you get a constant over infinity. Maybe you get infinity over constant. And maybe you get infinity over infinity. And similar rules apply here. If you get the constant right away, then that's good. That will be your answer. If you get a constant over infinity, well, infinity is really large, so from the eye of infinity, anything looks just like zero. So if you divide constant by infinity, then you get zero. If you get if you get infinity divided by constant, you'll either get infinity or negative infinity. And if you get infinity over infinity, once again, this is the troublesome case, so you'll have to simplify. So basically, these are the way that we can deal with the limit of algebraically.